This is Ubuntu 16 tutorial, and in this tutorial I'm gonna show you how to install Ubuntu 16.04 using pen drive or USB flash drive. Remember, this is not a dual boot tutorial. I have another video for dual boot. You can find the video link in my YouTube description as well as in my channel.
If you have older version of Ubuntu, such as Ubuntu 15.10 and Ubuntu 14.04 or older, don't worry, go ahead. The procedure is just same for the older version of Ubuntu or Windows. So let's start. Firstly, I'm going to download the Ubuntu ISO file. So open your browser, search for Ubuntu, hit it, go to download and desktop. There will be a link in my YouTube video description, and this is Ubuntu 16.04 LTS. If you were thinking to download an older version of Ubuntu, just hit alternative downloads and torrent. Let's see what's here. So you can find here download the network installer for Ubuntu 14.04 LTS, 12.04 LTS and 15. So let's go back. I'm gonna download Ubuntu 16.04 LTS, so hit download. If you are not a page, just click not now, take me to the download, then your download will be start. So that's it. So after downloading, open folder, connecting folder. So what you get here, Ubuntu 16.04 desktop AMD64, what means it is 64-bit Ubuntu. You should download what operating system you have. Let's see what I have. Just right click, then properties. Ubuntu is a Windows 64-bit operating system, 64-bit desktop processor. So if you get any option for choose bit, just choose SMS operating system that you have. So the next thing we need to do is download PowerISO. So open your browser, search for PowerISO, download. Then PowerISO, as I'm using 64-bit, I'm gonna download 64-bit. Downloads. So after downloading, show in folder, then install it. Yes. Agree. The next, install. The next thing we're gonna do is insert our USB flash drive or pen drive, whatever you say. I'll recommend you to having a flash drive at least 4GB or higher. So let's insert it, then format the flash drive, select FAT 32 and OK. Thank you. After that, open your downloads, then open it with Power ISO, then select tools and create bootable USB drive, then hit OK, then start, then hit OK. And after USB boot is done, click OK, then close, then click.
Now what you need to do is boot Ubuntu from Ubuntu from the pen drive that we prepared and install it. Now you need to find out the way for getting to the BIOS. It can be different for you to get into the BIOS. For my case, it is F2 button. This is my BIOS. For your BIOS, it might be looks different. Now I have to change the boot priority or boot order. Make USB's first priority. If you got CD or DVD, make CD as first priority, and when you make this, save it. For my case, it is F10 to save it. It can be different for you. You should know that if you done this before for installing operating system from USB, you don't have to do this again. So here we have two options: try Ubuntu without and install Ubuntu. As I'm going to install Ubuntu, I'm gonna select install, but if you want try, you can do that. You don't do any kind of change in your computer, then select install Ubuntu. I'll recommend you select both of these, as I don't have any internet connection, so I can't select it. But if you also can't, don't worry, just go ahead. Now if you want to select along with Windows, I'll say do not do this, do some advanced way and select something else, then continue.
Here we have two options: erase disk and install Ubuntu and something else. So select something else, then hit continue, then hit new partition table. Here I got 50 GB hard drive, so I'm gonna make new partition table for my personal file. So select free space, I'm gonna hit plus icon, then select file system, pick a size as you want. I'll make 20240, that means 2 GB, then hit OK. Now the thing you have to do is make 2 GB swap area. So select free space again, then select plus icon for swap area, make size equal 2024, that means 2 GB. Do not make swap area if you are using SSD, so use as swap area, then hit OK. So select free space, then hit plus icon again, use as journaling file system, mount point, and set mount point forward slash,
then OK. Device for bootloader and installation, set the full hard drive location, in my case deep slash forward slash SDA, then click install now, then continue.
Select your area, then continue, then select your keyboard and language, then select continue. Then type your name, your computer name, pick a password, choose a password or confirm password, then select continue. After that, sit tight and wait for continue.
After installing, click the register button and enter your password. This is Ubuntu 16 LTS. Thank you for watching. If you get any kind of problem or question, you can comment here. I will try my best to answer you.